Ni hao.
Ah, good, good.
No, I should say ni hao.
Excellent. Can you tell us more about you? Introduce you to
your
audience.
I'm Aarati Savur. I'm the CEO of Parisar Asha. Parisar Asha is a 35-year-old organization. It's an NGO, but it's really doing well, surviving, sustaining for 35 years. I think that is the biggest achievement for us in India. Mm-hmm. And this was started by one of the teacher. You know, we don't have any kind of support, like we don't have any corporate support or any political support. It was started by Gloria D'Souza, a founder, a teacher who wanted to change the education system in India.
Oh, why did he want to change the system?
We are still following the rote learning system. Mm-hmm. So there is no joy, there is no fun, and there is nothing what we are giving our children as a skill development, you know. Mm-hmm. We are just focusing on grades and we are not bothered later on, you know, what happens with them in their life.
We are not
able to compete with life, you know, because it's only rote learning, and children who have very good memory power, only they can do well. Mm-hmm. And children who has, you know, like other interests, then there is nothing happening much, you know, like
they couldn't really explore the interest area.
So imagine 35 years ago she wanted to change the education system.
Oh, that was 35 years ago. It's a
and
long way. How is it now?
So she was the first Ashoka fellow, and she was always a panel, you know, like for WISE also. So that's how I'm here, you know. So WISE, then LEGO, and you know that we have been very closely associated with the organizations. When I'm talking back and I'm taking forward her dream, you know, the vision and the mission of providing quality education to all, and that also through joyful learning system.
I see. Mm-hmm.
So we have our unique pedagogy, of course. Hats off to Gloria, you know, because this is all, it's her baby.
Okay.
She's no more now.
Elaborate a bit more on this.
Yeah. So,
how unique it is?
Absolutely. Yeah. We have this pedagogy called EASAL. EASAL is Environmental Studies Approach Towards Learning.
Oh, Environmental Approach Towards Learning.
Yeah, Environmental Studies Approach Towards Learning.
Tell us more about
it. Yes, absolutely. Because you speak different language, right? You speak Chinese.
I speak Chinese, yeah.
Yes, yeah. And I speak different languages. In India, you have so many multiple languages. So it's a small example.
Okay.
Why do you speak Chinese? Why don't you speak Hindi?
Okay.
Because the language you listen, you speak that language.
Yeah.
The kind of person you are today is because the kind of environment you have received.
Oh, the environment created
so
you, take you where you are.
So, environment plays very important role in anyone's life.
Yep, I agree, yep.
Okay, and especially the social environment, especially the academic environment plays very important role in a child's life, you know.
Yep.
That will depend, you know, that will decide the fate of that child.
Yeah, yeah.
So, what we are trying to do is, we are trying to create an environment, you know, that nurtures lifelong learning for the child, you know, and it is more holistic. So what we do in India, as I said, because we have a lot of rote learning still happening in the schools, because there are a lot of issues in India too, you know, there is poverty, there are a lot of students in one classroom, so teacher is not able to give that much of focus on each individual.
Yeah.
And unfortunately today, even nobody wants to take up teaching as a profession.
Why not?
Very few people are taking this as a passion, you know. The
teaching is a passion, not a profession.
It's not a profession.
Is it because teachers don't get paid well?
Yeah, that's also there. And another thing is, everybody today wants to do best, you know, like in their life. They want to earn a lot of money. They want to, you know, like they need prosperity in life.
Yeah.
So we find a lot of quality issues in teachers, and the passion is really lost. So that's where, you know, like considering all these aspects, we have fixed up all these areas, you know, like, and being an NGO, what we do is we work with the schools, we work with government schools, we work with private schools, underprivileged private schools. We don't cater to really high-end society. We do have some special modules for them also.
Mm-hmm.
But then you, when you have good money, you can always buy good education.
In India,
we have 80% people who can't afford quality education.
80%? 80%. That's a majority.
Yes. Yeah. So government says in India, right to education. We say at Parisar Asha, right to right education. What you are teaching, what you are learning, that also matters a lot, you know.
Yeah.
So in spite, of course, we need to really, you know, like develop their literacy and numeracy skills. Absolutely. They need to do well in their life. They have to get good grades. But at the same time, we also have to make sure what kind of human beings they are going to be.
Yeah.
You know, so along with knowledge, we also work on the skills, 21st century life skills.
What skills specifically?
Yeah, specifically, if you have heard about this 21st century life skills, there are four C's of 21st century.
Mm-hmm.
Are you aware of those four C's?
C?
Yeah,
beginning with C?
It starts with C.
Let me think. Just one word, right?
Guess now, because
creativity?
I said, absolutely, correct.
Confidence?
Very well, yeah.
Oh, thank you. Confidence?
No, confidence is the byproduct. Oh, it's the outcome. Yeah.
Creativity
is the attitude.
One of them.
Oh, okay. Confidence is the attitude.
Lucky guess. What are the other three?
Creativity, as rightly you said, then there is critical thinking.
Critical thinking. Oh, yeah. I agree with that. Yeah, that's really
collaboration.
Collaboration, okay.
Yeah, and communication.
Communication, okay.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, nice.
So these
four
C's are very important for anyone to be not only sustainable, you know, like in today's living, but also to be a successful human being.
Being, yes, yes.
See, we are talking here the success not in terms of only your professional success or your academic success. We are talking here about your holistic, you know, as a human being, how successful you are.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Because those are related to you, how you interact with others,
absolutely,
right? How
absolutely.
Your relationship with others
your
is.
Empathy.
That's very important.
Yes. It's very important today, you know. Mm-hmm. If you see all these big brands today or the big corporate houses, they will give more focus, emphasis on their emotional, behavior than your intellectual behavior, you know, because you can get trained anyways, you know, like you can go for tuitions, you can go for anything, but the behavior has to be nurtured, you know, it has to be, you have to create an environment. You cannot, you know, like there can be rote learning in behavioral changes. You have to showcase, you know, so that's where Parisar Asha helps these schools.
Mm-hmm.
So we have our own pedagogy. What we do is a school transformation in India. So we have different areas where we work with the school. It's a complete handholding given to the schools. Right from, you know, like helping them to plan their daily activities.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, because we talk about experiential learning, because when we are talking about environment, environment provides you different types of experiences.
Yes.
So we have to design those experiences for these children so that they will learn the right things.
I see. See, it's a design, curriculum?
Absolutely, right. Absolutely. Yeah. So we do this curriculum planning based on our state board syllabus only. So we are working in the framework of a government.
Oh, okay. So it has the support from the government?
Yes.
Okay, that's good.
Government doesn't support us because we are an NGO. Government really takes our support, you know, like we are working with a lot of government schools in India.
Oh, okay.
And where we had actually seen the results.
You are helping the government, actually.
Yeah, we are helping. Yeah, we are helping the government. We are helping also the society.
The society, yeah.
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 You know, in providing quality education, because as I said, not everybody can afford that quality education.
Yeah.
Where we are providing that at a very, very subsidized rate. So that's how we are sustaining. We take per student cost, the minimum cost from the private schools, and for government when we are working. So we try to find some donors over there. That is taken care of, because we have best of faculty available. Of faculties available, you know, like who are designing this entire thing.
Okay,
because ours is a center for educational training and research. So we need to have really talent bank over there, you know.
Yeah.
So we work with different medias and techniques. We are also, using a lot of theatre in education. We are using art in education. We are using play in education, you know.
Ah.
So using these multiple areas, we design our curriculum, we design the lesson plans,
mm-hmm.
we train the teachers. We go to the school and we train the teachers over there. Then we have a special facility called mentors. So our mentors,
okay.
yeah. So our mentors are the expert trainers. They go to the school for the hand-holding of the school, you know. They do the demo lessons mm-hmm. to the teachers.
For the teachers.
Yes, okay. because teachers are not used to this playway method.
Mm-hmm.
Because finally,
playway,
they,
right.
yeah, because they want to finish the curriculum. They feel, you know, if I start doing these activities, how will I complete my curriculum?
Yeah, 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 that's right.
But this is the way of completing your curriculum.
Oh, they have to think in a different
yes,
way, right?
Yes,
this is a
yes.
way to help you finish
yes,
the curriculum
absolutely.
More efficiently.
Yeah, because if you are just sitting and rote learning, how much are you going to retain? But instead of that, if you are actively involved in that activity, that learning is for lifetime for the child.
Yeah, 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 yeah. exactly. Yeah.
So that's where, you know, like we are bridging these gaps.
Mm-hmm.
And now what we realize that, okay, the schools are doing wonderful. Children are really happy in school.
Mm-hmm.
But when they go back to their homes,
yeah,
we don't have any control on their environment.
Yeah, so then
yeah.
what's going to happen?
So, you see, because only 6 hours are spent in the school, but the entire rest of the time they are there in the, you know, their homes.
Yeah.
Where, unfortunately, today parents are not aware how to, you know, like bring up their child, you know. In, how to create a good environment
at
for
home.
Them, yeah, at home. Because there are so, see, even in, I don't know about your country, but in India,
yeah.
especially if I'm talking about the city life, a lot of parents are independent. I mean, there is no more joint family system.
Mm.
So in joint family, you used to have this grandparents who will take care of your kids.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But now it's not like that, you know, and both the parents are working today.
Oh, okay.
So there is no time for with them. So what they give is the gadgets.
Mm, mm.
So the technology plays a very important role, you know, like in today's life,
yes,
in
yes.
the child's life.
Yeah.
So somewhere, you know, that connect, we are all virtually connected. Everybody is today on phone, WhatsApp and Facebook and Twitter
yeah, yeah.
and everything. But when you see face to face, we don't know what to talk and how to connect with each other.
Yeah, yeah.
You know,
yeah,
so
that,
these,
that's
are,
a problem
these
with
are the social,
with the social
skills, yeah,
yeah,
what,
yeah,
what are lacking
face.
Now, you
yes,
know,
yes,
in
yeah.
our children. Because we are only focusing on academics, we are only focusing on their tech savvy.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But as a human being, how successful you are going to be, you know?
Exactly. You have
yeah.
to really go out to,
yes.
to meet
so,
people, to have
yeah.
good relationship with people.
No, that's what we realize
yeah.
When these children, they have these problems. So
mm.
then they are sent to the counselors or psychologist or psychiatric. But we realize the problem creators are none other than their parents.
Mm.
So we started this helpline, specially.
Helpline.
Yeah.
yeah.
It's a toll-free helpline.
Toll-free.
Toll-free.
Oh, okay.
It's totally free. Any parent has problems with their child, so we first counsel the parents.
Mm.
We first realize where, you know, they are going wrong.
You have to stay
yes.
with stay at home, be
yeah.
with your kids
yes,
more.
Yes.
Something
so
like
you know how they can handle their child's problem, you know, so
yeah.
it's a completely free helpline, of course with the support of another
wow.
corporate house
yeah.
we have started, but I think this is the only one in India, you know, which helps the parenting
mm-hmm.
parent and child, you know.
Yeah, yeah, because there's an English phrase like father, like son, right?
Absolutely,
like mother,
absolutely,
like daughter,
absolutely.
Right?
So nobody else to be blamed for that.
Yes. Oh, that's
so,
good. So you're doing a very meaningful,
yes,
noble thing for the society. Yeah.
See, because finally what we realize, you know, what matters is the happiness.
Yes, happiness. Yeah.
yeah.
It's the ultimate goal, right?
Absolutely. So
yeah.
if we can have a happy child, tomorrow that child will become a very happy individual.
Mm-hmm. Then the happiness can be spread
yes,
around.
Yes,
yes.
Right. And we cannot buy this happiness outside.
Mm-hmm.
You have to create your own within.
Within, yeah.
Yes. So that's where, you know, like we train the teachers also how to, you know, like be happy, remain themselves happy. Otherwise, what happens? The frustration comes out on the child.
Yes, yes. and the teacher needs to really have the passion, right, for educating students.
Yeah. So we conduct a lot of activities, a lot of workshops for educators.
Wow.
We also have this special award, you know, like for
award.
Yeah, awards for teachers. Best Educators Award. In fact, I would also like your you know, country to participate in that.
Okay. Yeah. How we can participate?
Yeah, you can go on this Parisar Asha website and download the form.
Oh, so okay. it applies to all the teachers around the world, not just India.
Yes. Oh. So this is international. So you can, you know, go to Parisar Asha, P-A-R-I-S-A-R-A-S-H-A, Parisar Asha. Just Google Parisar Asha and you will get this Gloria D'Souza Excellence Award in Education. Mm. Download, fill up the form and send it back to us.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Then you will do the
evaluation. Then our jury will, you know, like evaluate and then we will be announcing the prize. And our event is going to happen on 11th of January 2018.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, that's the...
Yes.
During the Chinese New Year's time, I think. Yeah.
Oh, that's good. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So in a new year, maybe, you know, like you...
So it's a good news for you, right? Yes. To receive a prize if you're lucky, right?
Yes,
if you get selected.
Absolutely. You can get a prize.
Excellent.
And this is the way, you know, like we want to encourage our teachers to be more passionate about what they are doing.
And you're not restrained. You're open to the,
because
whole world.
See,
right?
This profession is very noble profession.
Yep. Teacher, yeah,
teacher,
indeed.
Because you are actually creating the destinies of
the future.
Your future.
The
absolutely.
Future of the country, the future
absolutely.
Of the society,
absolutely.
The future of the human being.
So luckily in past 35 years, we have been working with more than 1,000 schools very closely.
Wow.
And this year itself, you know, like we are touching almost 50,000 students only in this
50,000.
Academic year. Yeah.
Wow.
And plus, we also conduct free parenting sessions.
Mm-hmm.
Because as I told you, like we educate teachers, we educate students, we also want to educate parents.
The parents. Uh-huh.
So that we are, you know, because we are all collaborators in the child's learning.
Are those educating happening offline mostly or online as well?
No, not online support we do provide. But see, we are working in the pre-primary and primary and middle school years.
I see.
That's where, you know, like they actually needs to have that one-to-one feeling, you know, that feeling should be there.
Oh yeah, the one-to-one
emotions,
session. Yeah. Yes.
Emotions. So we complement that with online support and we complement that with digital support.
I see.
But that should not be your pedagogy of learning.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That can be like your teaching aid, you know, to enhance your teaching.
Yeah, I see.
Yeah, but not, you know, like actually, okay, just switch on, you know, like your digital board and then, you know, children are left to learn on their own independently. No. Because we want to develop, you know, it's a complete holistic development can only happen with senses.
Mm-hmm.
You know, when the child is engrossed in so many activities, exposed to so many different things.
Mm-hmm.
So that's how, you know, like Parisar Asha works in India.
Wow, good. It sounds like a, also like a prize-winning project.
So, yeah, we have been receiving many awards and accolades.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yes.
You really deserve that. Yeah.
Thank you so much. And this was a nice platform for us also, you know, to learn more. Mm-hmm. And I was so happy when I was listening to others, you know, all the top thinkers from the world who are here, that, okay, we are on the right track.
On the right track.
Yeah.
Because we're doing a very noble and meaningful thing.
Because what world is thinking now, we are actually doing that.
Yeah. You're doing that for the future education.
Absolutely.
Wow, excellent. Well, maybe one more question before we finish up here.
Sure.
Have you been to China before?
Yeah, I've been to China, but not
where?
On the, as I told you, Hong Kong and Shenzhen.
Southern part of China.
Yes.
What's the impression of China?
Oh, I love it. So when you invite us, definitely we'll be there.
Yeah, please do. But we are based in Beijing. Yeah, we'd love to welcome you in Beijing.
Okay. No, Beijing, I could not see. I had come on the tour, you know, like India, we conduct a lot of escorted tours. So
tours, okay,
yeah,
I see.
Then I was there.
Have you, or do you know something about, or how much do you know about Chinese educational system?
Actually, not really. I would be very interested to know more about that. Because see, whatever we read, it's, I don't think the actual things are, the facts are there.
Yeah, yeah. I think you're going to find many, I think from what you have told us, there are many similarities there. In China as well. We've got a lot of students working, you know, studying really hard for the grades, pass the exams. And what you are doing is something also kind of emerging and happening in China.
Oh, that's wonderful.
So it's really good. And I hope these kind of new changes to really combine students' interest with their grades to let them have to become lifelong learners in the future.
Absolutely. Yeah, yeah. See, because if we are thinking of a sustainable society for tomorrow,
Yes.
We really have to create, you know, like we really have to work hard on restructuring the entire thing.
Restructure the entire educational system.
Absolutely.
There's something not right
because
about old ones, you have to get rid of them. Yeah.
Because we are actually standing on a threshold. Anytime it will collapse, the system.
Excellent. Thank you for sharing that with us. Before we finish up here, do you have any other words that you may want to say to Chinese audience?
Just ni hao. No, what you saying?
Bye-bye. Zai jian.
What?
Zai jian.
Zai jian.
Yeah, that means goodbye.
Okay, zai jian.
Zai jian. Thank you so much.
Welcome.